Hello, I'm Ismail again. I have a new video while we are figuring out what's the best motor for my e-car. Now we are starting to develop my black box powering the AC motor. Our demo here is quite big motor. kilowatt and wired into 480 volts in a Y connection. You can see here, this is the terminal of the terminal 1, terminal 2, and we use capacitor. So it means we are only using 2 wires, and we just put some capacitor in series on another, the third terminal. Here is just a clip just to show you. We will run this motor in a very low current. Although this motor rated for 220 volts, something like 150 ampere and 60 ampere on, or on 220. Here it's written 75 ampere. So we just testing. The main thing why I need to test this motor, and this is the first time, is to make sure that we can control the RPM. The RPM of this is quite high, something like 1800 RPM. So the main point of my design here, first design, to use an AC motor for electric car, is how I can low speed the motor at the same time stop and go continuously to make sure if this is really will give a high current every time it started. Although there is no load, but just to show that I can slow speed the motor without overheating this coil winding of the motor. And here, this bank of batteries is for my testing on any experiment for DC motor. So here's how it looks. There is no wire outside except this one. This is my controller capacitor. So you can see the capacitor we will use is just this is in series, is less than 18 microfarad in series. This is 60 microfarad and series to 3, so it's less than 20 micro, something like 20 microfarad, but that's the initial test. And the coil is quite small, the other coil on the other side. So just for testing, this is the, like what we call it, still on infancy. So here, no connection here. Later on, once we put some torque power here, we will use this kind of capacitor. This is 3300 microfarad, 450 volts, several, a lot. It will be something like 10 pieces of this later on. But since we are on the initial test of this to know how we can low speed this big motor without giving us a lot of current to the input of the terminal of the motor. Okay, we can start now. Mm-hmm. vibration you can hear is from the plywood. Here. From the coil. And that's my antenna. You can stop. You can notice there is no converter except just a battery. Later on, this will reduce. This is a 240 volts, 260 volts battery in series. So later on, this will reduce to something like 5 pieces of battery. But the good things here, on my first design, initial testing of this very big motor, is I made it run without using an inverter. Just from the ambient, since the ambient is an AC form of wave, why not run the big motor even more? So I have here as well the small motor. Later on, this is part of our testing. And this one will reduce the backup battery into 2 pieces battery only. But that will be on the next stage of testing. But at this time, I'm quite happy that we able to run this very, very big motor. Look how big it is. So big, really big. And yet we run it in a very low current, and the good thing, at low speed, it did not go very high. So now we will make some several testing today and tomorrow, and the following day maybe I'll give you the next video. But at this time, what we can show is just running a motor low speed without overheating, without giving a high current on starting, from off to starting. And so that's all. See you next time again.